Hello student, today we are going to study Geography, Class 9, Chapter 2, Physical Features of India. This is the second part of the video. In the previous video, we have discussed about how the physical feature or the geographical feature of India used to emerge by the natural disaster, you can say the earthquake and by the volcanic activities. So at the what a particular place, they have the different surroundings, the different structure they have. Somewhere you find the hilly area, somewhere you find the plains, somewhere you find the desert, somewhere you find the ocean, somewhere you find the rivers. How the structure took place, you have the in your mind there are some questions you have, how they used to emerge. So all this thing we have learned that from the previous video, that like by the boundaries, the convergent boundary, the divergent boundary, the transfer boundary, or you can say the tectonic plates, by which when there was you can say the earthquake had happened or the volcanic activities had happened, when the downside of the landmass come upside, and they used to change or they used to give the physical feature of that particular place. So these are the things which we have discussed in the previous video. Then we come to know about the oldest landmass of this world, that is the Gondwana land, in which countries were used earlier, which countries were there? South America, South Africa, India, Australia, Antarctica. When the earthquake used to come, they used to apart from each other, that one of the landmass of the Gondwana to become the Eurasian plates. So these are the things which we have discussed in the previous video. Then we discussed about the major physical division. Only the one point we have discussed in detail about this is the Himalayan mountains. The Himalayan mountains starts from the north, that is the Kashmir, till the Arunachal Pradesh, that is in the northeastern, where you find all the mountains, the major mountains which we used to call the Great Himalayas, or we used to call it as the Himadri. They have the different, the Shivalik ranges, the Karakoram range, are all the things which you have learned. Then I will give you the fact that I used to give you the fact that in the Nepal, the only country on this globe where you find the 8 highest peak in a one line, when you can see from the sky, or when you go towards the, if you want to climb the Mount Everest, from that place you can see all these mountains. If you talk about the Mount Everest, if you talk about the Kanchenjunga, if you talk about the different other mountains, where you can see in the line someone on the highest peak, someone have their some of the meters of the, they have the certain ranges they have. Then you find the third one, the fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, just like that they are in the line. So now we are going further in this. You can see this map first if you're going to this. So it starts from north towards the northeast, from Kashmir to till Arunachal Pradesh, and they have given the names of the highest peak of the Himalaya. You can see the 11th page and this table, where some of the highest peak of the Himalaya, peak, the country and the height in meter. Mount Everest, which is in Nepal, that the meter is 8848. Then the second one is the Kanchenjunga, which is in India, that is 8598. Then the Makalu, that is in Nepal, 8481. Then the Dholagiri, that is in Nepal, 8172. Then is the Nanga Parva, that is in India, 8126. Then the Annapurna, that is again in the Nepal, where if you visit in Nepal, you will see the Annapurna ranges in the Pokhara, the place there where is in the Nepal. From that you can see the Annapurna ranges. If you're traveling over there on the road, you do not have to go nearby this Annapurna range. If you want to see this place, you can see from the Pokhara, height in the meter, that is 8078. Then the Nanda Devi, that is in India, 7817. Then there another one is the Comet, that is in India, 7756. Namcha Varva, that is in India, 7756. And the Gula Mahandatta, that is in Nepal, 7728. The fours of the Great Himalayas are the symmetric in nature, means they are the symmetric in nature. You have the idea, you have read in the maths what the symmetry is. Symmetric lies in this kind of structure, symmetric in nature, and asymmetric. A core of the part of the Himalayas is composed of granite. It is a perennial snowbound. There is a granite, and then on above that you will find the snow. Yani jo granite ka patthar ki tarah iske upar aapko kya dekhne ko milta hai? Snow. It is a perennial snowbound. a number of glacier descend from this ranges. इसी से बहुत सारे glaciers down side आते हैं. The range lying to the south of the Himadri, यानी इस हिमाद्री के south direct है, तो ये north में, पर उसका भी तो direction होगा जो कि south के direction में. The rugged mountain system known as Himachal or the lesser Himalayas, यानी ये है हमारा जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. Now it's a union territory, JNK and the Ladakh. Here you will find the Himachal Pradesh, this site where the name used to give the Himachal or the lesser Himalayas. The range are mainly composed of highly compressed and alternate rock. The highly there compressed and the alternate rocks where they find. The altitude varies between 3,700 and the 4,500 meters, and the average width is 50 kilometers. Now the particular, like the number of the mountains over there, so that the particular width is how much? 50 kilometers. Now we talk about the further. While the Pir Panjal range, from the longest to the most important range, that is the Dholadhar and the Mahabharat range are also prominent ones. This also you will find in the Himachal Pradesh. If you heard about the name, that is Kullu Manali, where the number of the people used to went over there for the tourism purpose, and they used to see the different ranges where you will find the different mountains with the different names. Some of the people used to go for the trekking, and then some of the people used to go for the mountaineering, or you can say they climb the mountain. So these are the certain things which we can see from this. Like it's like the downside of the Jammu and Kashmir, you will find the Himachal Pradesh, where you will find Kullu and Manali. The number of the tourists who went over there for the tourism purpose, and they will find the different ranges of the Himalayas, their name, their flora and fauna, the different vegetation they find, and how the people used to live over there. So the Dholagiri, the Mahabharat range are also the prominent ones. The range consists of famous valley Kashmir, the Kangra, the Kullu Valley in the Himachal Pradesh. And this region is well known for his the hill station, which I already explained to you. Now we come towards the next. If you talk about the Mussoorie, Mussoorie is in the Uttarakhand. If you talk about the Nainital, that is again in the Uttarakhand. So these are the places you will find in the India's map, and the state is the Uttar Pradesh. Now the outermost range of Himalaya is called the Shivaliks, means the outermost range. You can see here it's written over there, the Shivalik range. On the downside of the this is the brown in color, you will find this is the Shivalik range. You can see this map, and this is the Shivalik range. The extent over the width, what is the width they have, that is 10 to 50 kilometers, have the altitude varying from 900 to 1100 meters. They are having the range of 900 to 1100 meters. This range are composed of unconsolidated sediments and brought down the rivers from the main. Means जो कोई भी रिवर इस हिमालय रेंजेस में से इमर्ज्ड होती है तो अपने साथ बहुत सारे रॉक और सेडिमेंट्स लेकर आती है. यू कैन से द पेबल्स और रॉक्स व्हिच यूज्ड टू इरोड फ्रॉम दैट रिवर, द रिवर्स यूज्ड टू इमर्ज फ्रॉम द हिमालयस फ्रॉम ऑन दैट रिवर और इन दैट रिवर दे यूज्ड टू इरोड नंबर ऑफ द सेडिमेंट्स. यू कैन से द रॉक द पेबल्स एंड इरोडेड विथ एंड दे यूज्ड टू मेक अ सॉइल और द अलुवियल डिपॉजिट. हिमालय रेंज लोकेटेड द फर्दर मोस्ट. This valleys are covered with a thick gravel and the alluvium. The longer you lying between the Himalaya and the Shivalik are known as the dunes. यानी जो हिमालय के जो यहाँ पे जो नीचे जो ranges हैं, यानी इस side की तरफ हम जाते हैं from north towards the north east, तो जो उनके नीचे के side के valleys को हम क्या कहते हैं, dunes, जैसे कि धेरा दून, then कोटिल दून, then the पाटली दून, and some other well known dunes. So you have the idea about the धेरा दून, the Himalayan range. You can see this picture, the real image of the Himalayas. These are, you can say, the 12 months they are covered with the snow, and you will find sometimes you find white in color and somewhere you find black in color as well. But most of the time they used to cover it with the snow all the 12 months. Now we go further. Beside the longitude division, the Himalayan have been divided on the basis of the region from west to east. They are divided from eastern from the west to east. This division has been demarcated by the river valleys. So they are the river valleys. For example, the part of Himalaya lying between the East Indus and Satlas. Now you're thinking of that, where the Indus and Satlas emerge from. The Indus and Satlas emerge from this Himalaya. You can see this is the Indian and this one is the Satlas, which is going, or which used to come from, Indus used to come from Jammu and Kashmir, and Satlas used to come from the Punjab. that used to mix together and go towards the Pakistan. From that, from the Pakistan, he used to mix in the Arabian Sea. Has been the tradition known as the Punjab Himalayan, but it also known as the regionally Kashmir and the Himachal Himalaya from west to east respectively. कुछ जो ट्रेडिशन जो लोकल लोग हैं वो लोग क्या कहते हैं पंजाब हिमालय, बट अगर हम लोग थोड़े एविडेंस के रूप में तो इसको ये भी कहा जाता है कश्मीर एंड हिमाचल हिमालय फ्रॉम द वेस्ट टू ईस्ट रेस्पेक्टिवली. द पार्ट ऑफ हिमालय लाइंग बिटवीन द सदर्न एंड द काली रिवर इज नोन एज कुमाऊं हिमालय. यू कैन सी दिस इज द कुमाऊं हिमालय. आई विल शो यू दिस ऑन द कुमाऊं हिमालय. Where you find this rivers, see this range is the Kumon Himalayas, where the rivers used to emerge, in which the name of the river they have given, that is the Kali and the Tista demarcably the Nepal Himalayas. So here the Kali and the Tista river used to emerge. This is our Nepal. This is our Indian boundary. This is our Nepal. You will find the Tista and the Kali River. They used to demarcate the Nepal Himalayas. They used to call it the Nepal Himalayas. The part lying between the Tista and Diang River is known as the Assam Himalayas. So Diang River है उसको हम क्या बोलते हैं Assam Himalayas. And their regional name also in the three board categories. Find out some other names. But the what they try to say is that whatever the river they used to flow over there, according to the region they used to give the name. Just like Kashmir and Himachal region, then they used to give the name of Nepal Himalayas, and they used to give the name of the Assam Himalayas, because in the what the particular state the river is flowing, they used to give the name on the basis of that. If the river is flowing from Kashmir to Himachal Pradesh, Himachal Pradesh, they used to give the name as the Kashmir and Himalaya, Kashmir Himachal Himalaya. Now the river which are flowing to in the region of Assam, so they used to give the name of Assam Himalaya, and the river which is flowing in the nearby, or you can say in the Nepal, so they used to call the name as the Nepal Himalaya. Just like the river which are flowing in the Nepal, that is Tista and the Kali. If we talk the Assam, so there are the different rivers which are flowing over there. And if you know further, you can refer the atlas and you find the different rivers and you will find the different names of that particular region. The Brahmaputra marked the easternmost boundary of the Himalaya, the easternmost boundary of the Nepal. You can see this the Shangpo, which used to come from the China, and used when it used to come in the India, it's used to name as the Brahmaputra. You will going to know the further from this. The Brahmaputra easternmost boundary of the Himalayas beyond the Dihang Gorge is called the Dihang Gorge. The Himalayan band sharply to the south and spread along the eastern boundaries of the India. They are known as the Purvanchal. Yes, this used to call it Purvanchal, the eastern hills or the mountain. This to call this Purvanchal or the eastern boundary of the India. They are known as the Purvanchal eastern hills or the mountains. This hills running through the northeastern side. You see this you can see the hills or the mountains you will find in the northeastern state, or the, you can call it the seven sister state, are most composed of strong sandstone. They have the strong sandstones which are sedimentary rocks covered with the dense forest. The mostly run as the parallel ranges. This valley, the Purvanchal, comprises the Pakhai Hills, Naga Hills, and Manipur Hills, the Mizo Hills. Here you find this one is the picture of Mizo Hill in the Mizoram, where they give the name of Naga Hills, Mizo Hills. And this is the hills where you will find, if you went towards the Meghalaya, you will also find the different ranges where from there where you can see the Bangladesh. It's nearby the 2 kilometer, or nearby you can say the 1 kilometer. If you put one leg in the Bangladesh, or if you put the one leg in the India, so you will see that how the nearby we are, and you will see the different ranges where they used to say that, that the, some of the ranges are in the Bangladesh and some of the ranges are in the India. So we can say that we are that much of friendly, we can see this ranges. This is the picture of the Mizoram, where you can see this picture. There are the same images of you can see of the Meghalaya as well. If you want to know the four, the what the Himalaya, what kind of the ranges they have, and what are the name they have. You can see this valley, you can see the greenery, you can see the river there. Like they find the different types of things over there. Now we talk about the northern plains, how the northern plains are formed. When the from the mountains, the number of the river used to come, and in that river, what you will find? The number of the sediments, the number of the pebbles, or number of the rocks used to come, in which in that you will find the different types of things. They can do the numerous of the things. From the Himalayas, when the river used to emerge, in that river, the number of the sediments, number of the pebbles, number of the rocks used to come with that, and it used to come at that the faster rate that when the river used to mix with the ocean, but that particular thing like the sediments, the rock, the pebbles used to make a fertile land at the certain plane where they used to change their tributaries, when they used to change the river channels, or the particular river is to divide into number of the channels. Means जैसे गंगा हिमालय से मर्ज होती है, फिर उसके डिवाइडेशन काफी है, ट्रिब्यूटरी उसके चैनल्स काफी डिवाइड हो जाते हैं, और फिर उसको नाम दिया, जैसे कि भागीरथी है, अलकनंदा, वो गंगा के ही नाम है. जब वो अपने साथ जैसे बहुत सारी चीजें डिपॉजिट करके लाते हैं, जैसे कि सेडिमेंट्री है, सेडिमेंट्स है, रॉक है, पेबल है, तो उस वजह से जो एक प्लेन फॉर्म होता है, तो एक फर्टाइल लैंड होती है, इमर्ज होती है, जिसमें वही दिया गया है. द नॉर्दर्न प्लेन्स हैव बीन फॉर्मड बाय द इंटरफेस ऑफ थ्री मेजर रिवर्स, दैट इज द इंडस, the Indus which used to go towards the Pakistan, then used to mix with the Arabian Sea, then the Ganga and the Brahmaputra along with their tributaries, which I already explained. Tributaries means the river used to divide it in the different channels. This plain is form of the alluvial soil. So, ये क्या form करती है alluvial soil? This deposition of alluvial soil in the vast basin lying of the foothills of the Himalaya over the millions of the years form their fertile plain. Now spread over an area of 7 lakh square kilometer. कितने जगह फैला हुआ है? 7 lakh square kilometer. Plain being about 2,400 kilometer long and 240 to 320 kilometer broad. It is densely populated in physiographic region. Densely populated. Number of the people used to live nearby, or the you can say this particular places, because where there is the river, they have the very very fertile. They will get the very fertile land. They will get the different types of crops which they want to grow, and the human settlement is very much easy over there. And the number of the people used to get numerous of the thing at the very easy level, or you can say that at a very essential level, means. नंबर ऑफ द पीपल, यानी जो ज्यादा से ज्यादा लोग होते हैं, वो प्लेन रीजन में इसलिए रहते हैं कि उनको ये सारी चीजें काफी आसान तरीके से मिल जाती है, क्योंकि वो अगर हिली रीजन में रहे तो इतनी सारी चीजें आसानी से नहीं पा सकते. बिकॉज दे यूज टू डू द लॉट्स ऑफ हार्ड वर्क, इफ दे यूज टू लीव इन द प्लेन एरिया, सो दे यूज टू फाइंड दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग एट अ वेरी इजी लेवल. With a rich soil cover and combined with the adequate water supply, the favorite climate is the agriculture of productive part of India. Because we depend on the seasonal, so if the rainfall is very good, our agriculture is very good. If the rainfall is not that much good, so our agriculture is not that very much good. So the with a rich soil cover combined with the adequate water supply, the where there is a river, there you find the adequate water supply and the favorable climate change. So this is the agriculture productivity part of the India. You can see this northern plain, which you have seen this figure, how this person is doing their agriculture activities. Now go further. The river coming from the northern mountains are involved in the deposition of work. The river are coming from the northern mountains are involved in deposition work. Is the lowest course due to the gentle slope. The velocity of river decreases. Which result in the formation of the river island. जो मैंने आपको पहले ही बताया कि जब हिमालय से जब ये रिवर्स का इमर्जेंस होता है तो काफी फास्ट आती है, पर जब उसका स्लोप चेंज होता है, जब उसके वैलीज चेंज होता है, पानी क्या थोड़ा थोड़ा धीमे हो जाता है, और इस वजह से क्या है, फिर ये प्लेन फॉर्म होता है. बिकॉज द रिवर यूज टू डिवाइड इन द डिफरेंट ट्रिब्यूटरीज, और यू कैन से इन द डिफरेंट चैनल्स, और इट्स एंड यूज टू चेंज इन द डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन. सो दिस आर द थिंग्स वेयर वी कैन सी द हाउ द नॉर्दर्न plains have formed. Now, majorly in the Brahmaputra River is the largest inhabited river island in the world. Do you have the idea in the Brahmaputra where there is one island, the name is the Majuli, where there are the number of the people used to live at the particular island. The river is therefore the course split into the numerous of channels due to the deposit of slit. This channel is known as the distributaries, which I already explained. जब ये rivers जो है अपने साथ जो slit लेकर आती है, जो एक साथ जब deposit करती है तो उसको क्या कहा जाता है? Distributaries. But you have to keep this in mind. The northern plains is broadly divided into the three sections: the western plain, the northern plains, and the referred as the Punjab plains. Northern plains को Punjab plains भी कहा जाता है. Formed by the Indus and its tributary, Indus river से बना उसके tributary से. The larger part of plains lies in the Pakistan. जो ज़्यादातर उसका part है कहाँ रहता है? Pakistan में रहता है. The Indus and its tributaries are the Jhelum, Chenab and Ravi. जो Indus rivers में से जब you can refer this map to Indus rivers में से बनी, जो आपको ये दिखेगा. This is the Indus, this is the Chenab and Ravi. जो Indus rivers में से इसके three tributaries या three channels बन गए, जो कि towards where it used to go towards the Pakistan. Then Satluj originated from the Himalaya and the section is the plain Doab by the Doabs. यानी जो ये dominate करते हैं उसको क्या कहा जाता है? Doabs. Now तो you are thinking that what is the meaning of Doab is? The word Do means the two. And the ab meaning is water, meaning do pani. Similarly, Punjab is also the meaning of word. Punjab means, Panch means five. Because in the Punjab, there are the five rivers. On the basis of that, they put the name of that state is as the Punjab. The meaning, the Panch that is written over, the Panch means five. And ab means water, means the the five water is over there. So they used to put the name the Punjab as the on the basis of five river, they used to put the name of the Punjab as the Punjab. Now go further that the Ganga plain extend between the Ghaggar and the Teesta river. Ab jo Ganga plains hai, kya hai Ghaggar and the Teesta? It is spread over the state of North India. Ghaggar and Teesta used to come from the Himalayas, and this used to go to from the Nepal towards the India, then used to mix with the Bay of Bengal. It spread over the states of North India, Haryana, Delhi, UP, Bihar, and partly the Jharkhand and West Bengal to the east, and particularly in Assam lies the Brahmaputra plain. So ye kya banata hai? Brahmaputra plains banata hai, and they used to go towards the Bangladesh and used to mix with the Bay of Bengal. Now we talk about the northern plains are generally described as the flat land with no variation in the relief. Yani isme kya hame flat land dekhne ko milta, koi variation dekhne ko milta? It is not true. The vast plain also have the diversity feature. Yes, it's truth hai ki ye nahi ki humne plain land dekha to hame koi diversity nahi milega. Plain land pe bhi hame kafi sara diversion dekhne ko milta hai. Everywhere we don't find the flat land, we will see the diversions. So in according to the variation in the relief feature, the northern plains can be divided into four regions. The river after descending the mountain deposit favors narrow belt is about 8 to 60 km. Jo river northern plains se nikalti hai, phir jab jo deposit karti hai to uska jo narrow belt banta hai usko kitne kilometers mein hota hai? 8 to 16 km. If we go further, the with the lying parallel to the slope of the Shivalik, you can see this, the Shivalik ranges. Jab yahan se रिवर निकलती हैं और अपने साथ जो डिपॉजिट जो सेडिमेंट जो अपने साथ डिपॉजिट करके वो लाती है, इट्स हाउ मच ऑफ द किलोमीटर? दैट इज 8 to 16 किलोमीटर्स. फिर इट इज नोन एज द भावर, इसको भावर कहा जाता है. ऑल द स्ट्रीम्स डिसअपीयर इन द भावर बेल्ट, और जितने भी स्ट्रीम्स है, क्योंकि जो अलग अलग नदियां निकली होती हैं फिर वो साथ में आगे मिक्स हो जाता है, इसको क्या क्या भावर बेल्ट कहा जाता है? भावर बेल्ट दे यूज टू कॉल इट एज. साउथ ऑफ दिस बेल्ट द स्ट्रीम ऑफ द रिवर री इमर्ज टू क्रिएट अ बेल्ट. अब इसमें क्या होता है कि रिवर जो निकली होती है फिर अलग अलग चैनल्स में डिवाइड हो जाती है, फिर कहीं जाके फिर वो एक हो जाती है, फिर दोबारा से वो अलग होती है और अपना एक इसको वर्ड दिया गया है री इमर्ज, जो कि जो दोबारा से निकलती है अ क्रिएट अ बेल्ट, मतलब वेट मतलब गीला सा एक लैंड होता है, स्वैम्पी होता है, मार्शी रीजन होता है, इज नोन एज द तेराई. इसको क्या कहा जाता है? अर्लियर द भावर, नाउ द वर्ड इज द तेराई. This was a thickly forest region full of wildlife, where you will find you can say a greenery everywhere, where you find the forest everywhere and you will find the wild animals. So the forests have been cleared to create Now they used to clear or they used to cut the forest to they want the land for the agriculture. So to settle the migrants from the Pakistan and after the partition, because they want to settle the Pakistani people after the partition of the India and locate the Dudhwa National Park in the region. So the what they set up there, that is the Dudhwa National Park in this region. The largest part of the northern plains is from older alluvial soil. तो नॉर्दर्न प्लेन्स में जो हमें सबसे ज्यादा देखने को मिलता है ओल्डेस्ट दैट इज द अलुवियल इट लाइज अबो द फ्लड प्लेन्स यानी जो फ्लड प्लेन्स है फ्लड प्लेन्स किसको कहा जाता है कि जो रिवर्स है जैसे कि गंगा है एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द ब्रह्मपुत्र व्हेन देयर इज द रेनी सीजन दे फाइंड द हैवी रेनफॉल एंड ड्यू टू दैट देयर इज अ फ्लड सिचुएशन दैट वी यूज्ड टू कॉल द फ्लड प्लेन्स ऑफ द रिवर एंड द प्रेजेंट टेरेक ऑफ द फीचर द पार्ट इज नोन एज द भांगर में तो जहाँ पे ज्यादा रिवर का फ्लो है जहाँ पे बारिश आती है जगह फ्लड आने का वो रहता है उसको क्या कहा गया है भांगर द सॉइल ऑफ द रीजन कंटेन्स द कैलकास एंड डिपोजिट इसमें क्या जहाँ पे आपको कंकर देखने को मिलते हैं और द कैलकरस इफ यू फाइंड द डिपोजिट दैट इज कॉल्ड द कांकर द न्यूअर यंगर डिपोजिट द फ्लड प्लेन्स आर कॉल्ड द खादर जहाँ पे आपको नए और यंगर डिपोजिट जो नए नए जो पीपल्स है जो सेडिमेंट्स होते हैं जो मिलने को मिलते हैं फ्लड प्लेन्स में उसको कहा गया है खादर दे आर द रिन्यूड ऑलमोस्ट एवरी ईयर रिन्यूड होते हैं फर्टाइल होते हैं यानी काफी फर्टाइल लैंड फॉर्म करने में काफी मदद करते हैं आइडियल फॉर द इंटेंसिव एग्रीकल्चर मीन्स टू प्रोवाइड अ वेरी गुड एग्रीकल्चर तो स्टिल नाउ वॉट वी हैव डिस्कस इन दिस चैप्टर अबाउट ओनली द हिमालय माउंटेन्स एंड द नॉर्दर्न प्लेन्स इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द पेनिनसुला प्लेटू the Indian desert, the coastal plain in the islands. So till far what we have discussed that there are the 8 Himalayan ranges which we find in the Nepal, which is the only country on the globe where you find these 8 mountains. And the different regions of the India where you find the other mountains and which we come to know the how the rivers has emerged and how, from that like what the glaciers used to help us by which like number of the when the glacier used to melt then is to form the river from that river the number of the channels and the tributaries they were divided and on the basis of that how the land have formed how the fertile land had of the form how the sediments have the formed how the rocks and the pebbles or you can say the bhangar khadar all the deposit which have given the name they used to deposit in the soil and how they make the fertile land for the agriculture how in the northern place the number of the people used to live at the particular place because they used to get the fertile land they used to get the pebbles they used to get the rock they used to get the stone so these are the certain thing which they find and on the particular on the basis of that when because they used to live at the plains they used to find each and everything at a very easy level why the people used to go towards the Himalayan region because they have to do lots of hard work and don't find the certain things so in this case we have learned about from the Indus which river channels has divided what are the names of the Jhelum river Ravi and Satluj then we talk about the further from the Ganga that is the Alaknanda and the Alaknanda then they give the different types of the name by which they used to deposit the numerous of the you can say the alluvials which used to give them the name the alluvium which is the good amount of the delta they used to make in the further lectures you will come to know how the delta used to make and how this peninsula plateau from which river they emerged how deposit what are the deposit they made what are the name they have or in which sea and the ocean they used to mix with if we talk about the desert we will talk about the different desert of India especially the Thar desert which is the highest or you can say the only the one place in our India or the two state that is the Gujarat and the Rajasthan the Thar desert which is the highest or you can see the biggest desert you will find in India and the one is the white desert which you find in the Gujarat if we talk about the coastal plains then we will talk about the different state and the sea and the coast areas and the harbor areas where we talk about what the particular features we have what the sea we have what kind of ports or the export import things we are doing and what the kind of the rivers used to mix with the ocean. Then we talked about later on the island, that the Lakshadweep and the Andaman Nicobar, how they used to become, and what the features they have, what the kind of forest they have, and how the people lived over there. I hope you like this video. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the Peninsular Plateau, the Indian Desert, the Coastal Plains, and the islands. Thank you.